Hello, my name is Arjen van der Wal from Praktika Foundation, and in this training module we will talk about the different manual drilling techniques. We will talk about the selection of well construction methods. There are different ways to construct a safe water point. We will talk about the quality of manual drilled wells. We will talk about four different manual drilling methods to drill a water well, and we will talk about training and handbooks that are available to train enterprises, quality controllers and NGOs. There are three ways to construct a safe water point by making a hole in the ground. The first one is doing a machine drilling. You can also make a concrete lined Hendrick well, and as an alternative you can go to manual drilling. Machine drilling is a very high quality way of drilling water wells. It has a high water quality and a high yield. The disadvantage though is that it can be very expensive. For a 30 meter water well, you will pay about $5,000 to $15,000. Concrete lined Hendrick wells are ideal in situations where you have a less permeable aquifer because of their capacity to store water. But often, because you penetrate the first few meters of the aquifer, a lower quality of water and a lower yield can be expected. Lined Hendrick wells do have a lot of concrete inside and are therefore expensive. Local wells, without any concrete lining, are cheap, but they easily cave in. Manual drilling could be an option if you are drilling in sandy soils or you need to drill deeper than a Hendrick well. The water is high in quality and it's way sufficient for to be equipped with a hand pump. Wells could be cheap, for $100 when you go for irrigation, too more expensive when you want to use it for communal drinking water. Quality of manual drilling is a choice. There are different ways of drilling a hole. You can drill a small hole using cheap tools. You can make a bigger hole, a deeper hole, using more expensive tools. You can also equip the well with just a PVC pipe that you buy in the store, or with high quality blue pipes that are used in machine drilling. As like for every product, the quality of a well depends on the money that you spend on the well. A farmer who has a low budget, he can buy a very cheap well, very small hole with a very cheap PVC casing to start irrigation. In that case, it's called self-supply and it's affordable to the farmer. So he can go directly to the manual drilling enterprise and order a well. For communal water points, you can drill a hole of a large diameter, which is 40 meters deep, and equip it with a high quality PVC pipe. Put in a sanitary seal, a gravel pack, and then you will have a very good well for communal use. Although it will not be affordable for the users, it's very affordable for the donors because it's still a lot cheaper than the machine drilled wells. The quality of manual drilled wells. The water quality is often equal to the water quality of a machine drilled well because once you find pollution, you are able to drill deeper. With manual drilling, you may be able to drill to 40 meters. The well can be equipped with any type of hand pump, so not only cheap pumps can be put on a well which is manually drilled. You also could put an Indian mark on it and then it looks exactly the same as when you would have drilled the well by machines. To help you to guarantee the quality of manual drilled wells, national standards can be developed together with the local government. The national standards is a list of technical details which will tell you the diameter of the borehole, the type of PVC that you use, the gravel pack, the sanitary seal. It's a whole list of specifications. The specifications can be used by organizations to attach them to a tender. The organizations or the specifications can help the enterprises as a guideline. They will know from the specifications what to install, what PVC to buy. The quality controllers can use the specifications to check the work of the enterprises. In Tjaart, for example, manual drilling is now part of the national policy. And together with the government of Tjaart, national quality standards were developed, which are now used by organizations, drilling enterprises and quality controllers to guarantee the quality of the wells. There are four manual drilling methods: jetting, hand auger, percussion and sludging. There are many more variations known in different countries, but all four will work against one of these four principles. The jetting. The jetting drills with water circulation. Here we have the jetting pipes. Water is injected in the pipes and at the bottom it will turn around and come up in the borehole, carrying the cuttings to the surface. The cuttings will then settle in one of the mud pits and the water is recirculated back into the well. Jetting is very quick in sand. The disadvantage is that it needs a lot of water for working. One of the big advantages of being very quick is that you can drill in sand a water well 40 or 250 meters in one day time. The depth that you can drill with jetting is 35 to 50 meters, depending on the geology. If you're drilling in sand, like in the Sahel regions, for example, Chad, a 50 meter well is possible. If you're drilling in Ethiopia, where you have a lot of clay, jetting may not be the right drilling technology. Another technology is called percussion. It's actually drilling with a heavy hammering bit. A heavy hammering bit is attached to a rope and it's lowered into the well, to the bottom of the well. Percussion is typically used when you encounter laterite layers or big boulders. The drilling bit will be moved up and down with a rope and it will crush the stone on the bottom of the borehole. The stones are then crushed to gravel and the gravel is extracted by using a baler. The advantage is that of all the manual drilling methods, percussion is the strongest one and drills very hard formation. The disadvantage though is that it's very slow compared to other methods because most of the time it's used when you're drilling through hard rock formations or through laterite layers. And that will sometimes give you just a few meters to drill per day. The depth that we use percussion drilling for is about 25 meters, although in the 1800s percussion was used as a method to drill oil wells. With the hand auger, you will use steel rods which are attached to each other. The advantage is that it's very easy to drill and very quick to drill shallow water wells. The disadvantage is that it's limited in depth because you are lowering a casing down in the aquifer during drilling. And each time that your drilling bit is filled with sand or clay, you have to bring it out all the way up to empty it. For a 8 to 12 to 15, sometimes 20 meter hole, hand augering is okay, but for deeper holes, it will take too much effort and too much time. The average depth, well, let's say 15 to 25 meters. Very suitable in sandy conditions. The last method is sludging. Sludging also works with water circulation, but it's actually the reverse of jetting. This time, the water from the pit goes down into the borehole and comes up in a sludging pipe. The water is directed back into the mud pit where the cuttings will settle. Sludging is especially very good in clay. So in countries like Tanzania, Madagascar or Ethiopia, where you find thick clay layers, sludging will drill easily through. It's easy to use. The disadvantage is it will take a few days to drill a water well, and all this time the working water has to be maintained. So just like with the jetting, you have to have access to working water. General depth for sludging is about 35 meters. To support the capacity building process and technical training sessions, a series of handbooks have been written. The Manual Understanding Groundwater and Wells is an instruction handbook. Whatever drilling method you're using, or even if you use machines to drill water wells, this instruction book will give you a good background on hydrogeology, hygiene for well drilling, well installation and well development. It will tell you how you can protect your well from any contamination, so you can drill a safe water point. For the four manual drilling methods, there is a manual available or will be available by December 2010 for the sludging. These four books will have a step-by-step approach. Step-by-step, they will explain the drilling process. It has a module for the NGO or the organization to see how they can implement manual drilling. And it will have a third module, which is for the local production of the drilling tools. The second module of each of these technical handbooks gives you step-by-step in cartoons an explanation on how to use the drilling methods. From E to Z, every manual has about 30 different cartoons to show you how to use the tools to make a hole in the ground. How you finish the hole, what type of PVC casing, and how do you drilling books are details that can be found in the first manual, Understanding Groundwater and Wells. These manuals are just meant as a guideline how to use the tools to drill a hole in the soil. The third module of each manual will contain technical drawings with dimensions so that local workshops will be able to produce all the bits and pieces, all the tools and equipment needed for a manual drilling enterprise to start. With these tools and the input of a technical trainer, you will be able to construct quite high quality tools, which are only a fraction of the cost than imported tools. The handbooks are used during the entire training process. Handbooks are not just used for a single training, or even using handbooks alone is not enough. Manual drilling can be seen as a real profession. So they will be used as a background document while training, while giving follow-up, while coaching and retraining. Capacity building, as we've seen, is a whole process. The handbooks are used as a reference book when the trainer is away for the drillers to look back how to do certain actions. To summarize, quality of manually drilled wells is high. National quality standards for manually drilled wells will help you to guarantee the quality of the wells. There are four manual drilling methods to drill high quality water wells. Manual drilling is a real profession. There are handbooks and training available and they provide much useful information. But experienced trainers are always needed for training and coaching throughout the whole capacity building process. As you have seen, capacity building is hard work. It takes a lot of effort, but the results are worth it. Thank you.